We kindly welcome everyone to this impromptu session. ஐயா நீங்க நேம் யார் யார் கொடுத்துருக்காங்க தெரியுங்களா?
வாழி சொல்லு ஐயா. ரவி ஆறுமுகம் ஐயா கொடுத்துருக்காங்க,
ஐயா வல்லியம் ஐயா,
பூர்ணிமா அம்மா இருக்காங்க.
சரிங்க,
ரெண்டு பேர் தாங்க ஐயா பொதுக்கி கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. அப்படியே போகும்பொழுது தொடர்ந்து அப்படி பேசலாம் ஐயா.
சரி சரி, ஓகே. We warmly welcome பூர்ணிமா தனஞ்சயன் அம்மா to present the impromptu session.
Be blessed by the divine ayya. Can you please allow for sharing?
I think Arulaya, I think you may have to, yeah, just a minute. Well, you can start this.
Can I?
Yes, Amma. Ayya has given you the co-host privilege.
I gave the host to Pradeepayya. Pradeepayya, hopefully you will be able to spend time and coordinate the session all the way till the end.
Sure, yeah, I will do that. Thank you. All good.
Ayya, Chundaram Ayya, neenga share pannirukka.
It's visible, Ayya?
Yes, Amma. It's visible. You can go forward.
Be blessed by the divine. Good morning and good evening, one and all. Today we are going to discuss in a new perspective of the topic illadam. Our life sole purpose is realization of divinity, so knowledge acquirement. In early days, people achieve this by following the path of sannyas and doing rigorous tapas without leading a normal family life. But can we achieve the same after following a routine family life as well? Yes, it can be. The legend and spiritual guru Tiruvalluvar and our Maharishi have proved the same through their life. Let's see what is Illadam. Illadam means the person who takes care of parents and life partner and their children is the good householder. The person who takes off family responsibilities should take care of the parents of both. Is taking care of parents both side, parents should be treated equally with respect and dignity. Ilvalvan enban iyalbudaiya moovarkum nallatsin ninsa thunai. The parents should take care of children's education and should take care of discipline and the responsibility in the proper manner. For that, Maharishi says the parents can spend their efforts and time and energy for children's proper growth. Love and affection. If the married life possesses love and virtue, this will be both its duty and rewards. If we start showing the love between the family members, it creates peace and harmony in the family. Chastity is a virtue that can be admired more than life by men and women. If you lose our chastity, it will be affected our physical health and mental well-being. And then the Kural 42 says, he will be said the flourishing in domestic virtue who aids for second the poor and the needy people. And duties of family man, the duty of the householder is to preserve the fivefold rule towards the man's, the God, his guest and relations and his family. Tenpulatha means who meditate on Agna and Duriya. To perform these duties, we have to need to do proper meditation. If we keep good people photograph in our home, make a changes in our mind, and it provides peace also. Ancient peoples classified the life into four stages called Brahmacharyam, Grahastham, Vanaprastham, and Sannyasam. By doing Manavalakkala Yoga, we can attain these four stages. The man how live in the life in proper manner will be compared with God, and we can get the knowledge in our Manavalakkalai Yoga. So doing our yoga in our Manavalakkalai Yoga, we can lead our life by proper manner, by staying home and getting eternal peace and serve the society happily. A happy family, a happy society. Development starts from home and family. It will build building blocks of attaining divinity. So let's all achieve the same from our Manavalakkalai Yoga. Thank you, Ayya. Be blessed by the divine.
Thank you, Amma. Bhagi Lakshmi Amma, would you like to share some thoughts on the presentation?
Be blessed by the divine. வாழ்க வளமுடன் பொர்ணி மாமா.
Be blessed by the divine அம்மா.
Be blessed by the
divine. Basically you are giving feedback and summarize. So basically
okay.
Primarily feedback அம்மா.
Okay. Yeah, I tried. Okay. Really very well presented அம்மா. Really started with the family and you gave examples of திருவள்ளுவர் and மகரிஷி, those who are in family and they how they lead it the spiritual life and how they are example to us and what are the duties to be done by the family man and what are the rewards they get and the five duties, five stages and all that are very, very well explained. And when we are talking about that four stages, brahmacharyam, grahastham, vanaprastham and sannyasam, here we can just add one more point there. In our Manavalakkalai Yoga, that grahastham and vanaprastham are joined together. There is no separate vanaprastham here. That vanaprastham is changed into meditation and introspection. So there is no point in leaving the house and going out and do meditation. That is what happened in olden days. Actually, Swamiji gave us that two together, that Ildaram and Akathavam together. So that can be added here. I think that will be a value point here where we have to realize and do it. That is what we are doing in our life now. Yes. And sannyasam, actually here, Swamiji, that's a service to the society. The world, the charity that is Thunder. So other rest of it is really good Amma. And anybody else is going to talk about the same topic or shall I continue and give some more points in this?
Amma, I think you can move forward. We have Ravi Ayya, but I think okay. We'll ask him to share his thoughts after your feedback.
Okay. So here to lead a family life, that is whatever we want, we can definitely get it in a family. We say that no pan paduvathu kudumbathil payan paduvathu samudayathil. So we can easily develop ourselves and tune ourselves and everything within the family. So all that comes in illaram, that Swamiji used to give that in the topic peaceful family, how to lead the family in a peaceful manner. So that also can be taken here, and only the consciousness to be the to take place, and in at any circumstances we should not use our emotional feelings. All that can be added, and the same way within the family members there should not be a command and demand. That is, we should not try to find fault with others. Even if they do any mistakes, if we want to correct them, we can just tell them with the love and affection. That love and affection is very, very important to lead a family. It's for every family member, for each and every family member that has to be added. And at the same time, no commanding also. We should not command that do this. See, most of the houses, one who's earning will have that in their mind. And I'm earning, so I know everyone should listen to me like that. See, that time we don't realize after a few years, somebody else will take over. Suppose now father is earning, after 20 years, son will be earning. So that time, the same, if that happens again, then there will be an ego clash in the family. So we should realize that it's only our duty. So we should not comment on others. At the same time, no demanding also. So demand is also like, see, we force others to do, you do this. Since I want it, you do this, like that. That type of demanding can be avoided to lead a family life. That is peaceful life. And always, the and in most of the family, when we talk about the life partner, they say, I thought of marrying that man, I thought of marrying this girl, but somebody told that this guy is good, that girl is good, but now I'm getting into trouble, all that. But here we must realize that it only because of our genetic center and because of the super consciousness state, we get a life partner. If our genetic center is good, and if we according to that, we get a life partner. So if we get a good life partner and if we are enjoying our life, then we can just give a round of applause to our own self, say that our genetic center is good. If not, if it is in the other way round, where we have to adjust, we all that adjustment. Here Swamiji also say three more things, right? Adjustment, tolerance, and sacrifice. That also needed. So we have, so always, even that one more thing also Swamiji used to say, right? Adjustment means who should adjust in the family. One who is really intelligent, more intelligent should adjust in the family. So now every one of us will say, no, I'm only intelligent. So let us take that adjustment and lead a happy life. So to cross our aim, that is the purpose of life, definitely we must be only in family. That is illaram, illaram alladhu nallaram andru. So, and people talk about thuravaram also. So thuravaram is not just leaving the family and going out. Thuravaram is while being in the family, leading a life with attached detachment. We used to learn in this moralization of desire topic, uravile kanda unmai nilai telive thuravu. So we have to follow that concept every now and then. That is nothing but vanaprastham actually. So both together gives us the illaram. So illaram is called peraram. So illaram is not thuravaram. Within the family, you must know why the limits and methods, and that gives us the peraram. Thank you.
Thank you, Amma. Next, we kindly request Ravi Arumugamayya to present his thoughts on the improv session topic.
Thank you.
I think he hasn't joined the audio yet, I believe.
Yes, sir. Maybe Anita Chandrasekharma, we can call.
Yeah, okay. Anita, ma, would you like to share some thoughts? I've unmuted you, ma.
Oh. We need to start the recording. Something happened. Okay. Yeah.
Be blessed by the divine. And thank you all for the opportunity. I would like to think about the family, illaram. I'll just share what I thought and then and explain what I feel as illaram. So, illaram or family
So when we start, as I'll just share my experience of what is Illyrium, like how I understood, and then we'll go from there. So when we started as a family, we started as a family here, and the day we started, we thought that mutual responsibility is the core thing for our good lead of life, and we proceed through that, and then there were like so many happy moments, so many differences, and all that happened, and then there is every one of us in this meeting would have experienced that is the like becoming a father and mother after getting married. So when that happened, every man who gave birth, every man and every parent who gave birth in US had a great opportunity of being with the mother during the delivery. So that moment happened to me as well. So till that, in our life, whenever we have moments, we'll always have differences, and we'll always have the difference of opinion. So those things happened a lot. When this beautiful moment happened, and the things were changed, that's the moment when I witnessed what is meant by love and compassion. So when my wife gave a birth to my daughter, there is a formality here in US where father is the one who has to cut the umbilical cord between mom and the kid. So till that, I was very rigid, and I felt like I didn't lose my control. But the moment when that happened, that's when I understood actually what is mean by losing ourselves. So when that moment happened, I started crying. I don't know whether it is really I don't know the feeling why that happened, and I hold my daughter, and so after that, when I tried to think through that, because by the grace of our guru, we got a great gift that Sollal Mattum Nambade Suyamai Sindhithe Aruvai, even if it is applicable to whatever the feel we get also. So whenever I get that feeling, whenever I think through those with my mind, I couldn't recollect the things around me, the things except me, my wife and daughter. I couldn't recollect so many of the scenes which I witnessed there. So when I tried to think through, the first thing which came into my mind was the first feeling which I got is the gratitude. When that gratitude came in, I was like, so that's when my mind started losing it, meaning like it just lose control and started melting itself. So when that happened, then naturally my mind go back and recollect so many past events happened in my life, and how I am here, and what were all the things happened, and each and every moment in the past is pushed to the next level because of this inherent gratitude which is there in me, which moves me from a different state in my life to here. So when my mind started resonating those things, I realized that even this mind think in a completely different manner, and then even more cunning, but this mind is thinking completely so subtle, and it was
very pleaseful and pleasant. And the reason for all is the gratitude which I got on each and every moment. And when I go deep on that, there was a melting point where my mind refused to think. My mind refused to analyze. My mind refused to refused to give any explanations to that. That is when my mind liked to enjoy the moment. So when that happened, I completely realized that the core of each and every gratitude moment in my life I had is because of pure love and compassion. That's the bone of each and every gratitude moment. So when that happened, my mind stops thinking and starts enjoying. So when that enjoyment started, I completely realized that the moment of enjoyment, the momentary experience what I get is because of the pure love and compassion. And each and every moment, the moment now, the moment passed away, the moment is going to come, it's all think by the present mind. And when the mind is closely on that stage, closely on that state, our pure consciousness is exposing itself as a perennial flow of love and compassion. And that's when I realized that I got all this because of a structure called family. So without the sacrifices of my mom, without the sacrifices of my relatives, without the sacrifice of my wife, there are so many well-wishers we have in our life, and that sacrifice has the core as love and compassion within them. It is happening unconsciously or without their knowledge. It just stays there as a uirpu, I would say in Tamil, uirpu. And that is what came out as a sacrifice. And that sacrifice is being realized by the person who consumes as a gratitude. And when that guy tried to hold the gratitude for long, and that gratitude will naturally expose itself as love and compassion. And those are all the understanding I got through the life I lead. And I hope each and every one of us will have the same kind of life experiences, moments. And when we try to think through that, we don't need to think that we are thinking the past or future. We can only do that with the present state of mind. So whatever thought we think, it's all in present. So that's what we have to realize. So presence is the only thing we have. And when this particular thing is being realized by everybody, and we need to thank our guru to help us think through all this. Sindhanayai Udal Nalathai Vivitha Guru. So we have to thank our guru. So if we think all that and get the love and compassion of what we experienced as a family, with the family relationships and all that, when we think of our guru, he came to us from nowhere. I'm just talking from my mind. It didn't happen like that. It is everywhere, and it is there. But when we think through from a moving consciousness as a mind, so he just came from nowhere, and then he just pour his love and compassion on us, and then we start thinking through, and then that leads to the experience of truth, which is pure love and compassion, and the pure consciousness is sunainir, like it just
it's a perennial flow. So when it happens, then we'll feel the pure love and compassion, and that love and compassion is what can be experienced pretty quickly in anybody's lifetime if they have a family. So the only thing we need to follow is, as per Magrishi, we need to follow ATS, that is like adjustment, tolerance, and sacrifice. So if we follow that, or if we get hold on to the situation and try to cross it, if we do once, then we'll realize that it's not something we do. It's happening through divine. And when we witness one moment in our life like this, then each and every moment before, after, now, everything is because of this pure love and compassion of pure consciousness. And that's the moment of realization. So the best place to realize oneself and be a form of love and compassion is family. That's what I feel. Thank you to Guru, our beloved Guru. Be blessed by the divine. Thank you, Amma. Thank you, Aya.
Thank you, Aya.
Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. Karthikeyan Aya, Valka Valamudan.
Thank you, Amma. Valka Valamudan.
Really, you took us for a beautiful journey of your family. We travel along with you, and we could visualize what happened, what would have happened, how you were. And really, always that personal experience add on values here. And generally, Swamiji used to say that the first child in the family is for the boy and the girl only. The next child is for only for the husband and wife. They realize what is later only. But your experience is entirely different. And at the beginning, you had the difference of opinion, and you realized about the love and compassion later. And cutting the umbilical cord, that's really a lovely experience.
I can't explain it actually.
We can understand that situation, and that touch of the umbilical cord, even now if you think of that, no, you feel that softness.
I'm just crying and talking.
That's a lovable moment. And really, those who are having the chance of that touching and feel of that umbilical cord, no, really they are boon. They really got blessed only, I can say. Really, you people are really blessed there. And actually, even I had that opportunity to touch and feel that umbilical cord. That's why I could feel how you would have felt it.
my wife's mom was also there in the delivery room. Okay. And that is actually her moment of realization. So she was like completely blown away. After that, the whole relationship turned around upside down.
Definitely. Actually, they say no, there may be many reasons for separation, but there must be only one proper reason to unite. So here, yeah, that one reason is nothing but the love and compassion. Yeah. So once, yes, that attitude, you rightly said that peaceful and pleasant moment, right? Yes. And the consciousness perennial exposed to the flow. That flow we could feel even now, that flows on you.
I hope I resonate better to everybody. I hope everybody will have some moments in their life like this. And that if they understand the gratitude part first and then melt on that gratitude part, the love and compassion is just behind the screens. And when we open the screen, that's it. We couldn't explain it.
Yeah, that's what it's a very good recall session. And actually, as I told you in the beginning, we really travel along with you only. And we say, no, we are living for the, it's better to live for the present. No need to think about the past or the future. You try to That's what you said, no? You were there that that moment. You forget everything. What is happening around? You don't know what is around. So that is the real way of living. You live for the present. See, that is only the oneness. Actually, when we talk about God, or when we ask, where is God? Is God here? We can't say God was there. We can't say that in the past tense. Same way, we can't say God will be there. So whenever we talk about God, we say God is here, right? God is here. Is only. So that so if you say God was there, we'll definitely ask, will not be here or there, or something like that. So living for presence is nothing but living with the consciousness. So you really made it.
Thank you.
Very nice.
So when I had a discussion with one of my friend about this consciousness, he was explaining that he's also a good thinker and realizer. So he was like telling me that the momentary experience is actually God, is what he explained.
Yeah, that's right.
I was like, that was the greatest understanding and experience. Then I started applying that when I realized the gratitude to love. I applied that, and then I realized that every moment is love and compassion. Every moment is because of pure consciousness.
Certainly. Yeah. So
thank you.
Even when we talk about the child care, Swamiji used to say both husband and wife have an equal responsibility in matters concerning the children. And the practice of Manavadakala helps maintain the peace and goodwill with the family. So I hope you all are doing that, and definitely the family will be a model for the others in the society, and everyone should look at us and read the Manavadakala. Yes, they should learn and practice and implement in their life. So definitely they will have peaceful in the family. Yes. And as Purnima ma'am said, that happy family, happy society, right? So we are marching towards that only. Thank you. Thank you very much, Karthikeyanayya. Lovely session.
Thank you. Thank you,
Amma. Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by
Thank you, Amma. Anita ma, I see that you have joined in a different name. Would you like to share your thoughts?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Be blessed by the divine.
Go ahead, Amma.
Be blessed by the divine. Hello, everybody. Thanks for coming here today. I will be present a speech on the topic, Tree Within the Seed. There is a wonderful quote, Maharshi's Jnanam Vazhum book, quoting as, Marathinile vidayum, and the vithinil maram pol, manidhanukkul deivam, and the deivathirkul manidhan. You can find out this line in the song 192, which in page number 136. As an example, when we look at the banyan tree, we only think about the beauty of few branches and aerial fruits of that tree. Even if the tree is bigger, but it is generated from the small seed only. As the above example, even in the body of everyone, divinity is present. Even and every human being has their own magnetic power. The center point of this power is known as genetic center. The divinity is present in the genetic point. The secrets of universe, most of our life experience is covered here. Human body is working with three principles: physical structure, astral body, and magnetic wave force. All the three combined in every action of body and mind. According to the specific gravity system, whatever is moving around self-moving, and the heavier things are going inside, lighter things are coming outside. That means the spinning action densified portion goes the body center. Every aeroplane have a black box, where every incident that happens will be recorded. So in human body, this genetic center is the black box from our birth to death. Whatever goods or bads we have done will be recorded in this genetic black box. We can say this as God plus imprints equal to man. Man minus imprints equal to God. Quote from Maharishi. காந்த நிலை அறியாமல் கடவுள் நிலை அறிவதோ கருமையம் அறியாமல் அறிவினை அறிவதோ. இன் திஸ் கோட் மகர்ஷி எக்ஸ்பிளைன்ட் அபவுட் த டிவைனிட்டி பிரசன்ட் இன் அவர் பாடி. த எக்ஸாக்ட் பாயிண்ட் வேர் திஸ் ஜெனடிக் சென்டர் இஸ் பிரசன்ட் இன் அவர் பாடி இஸ் த சென்டர் பாயிண்ட் ஃப்ரம் டாப் டு பாட்டம்.
Sorry, not able to hear.
Extracting to the incidents from the genetic center and converting into thoughts. There are three karmas in genetic center as imprints. So they are Sanjita karma. This karma is retrieved from our ancestors as hereditary. And second one is Prarabdha karma. This type of karma recording our goods and bads which we have done from the date of birth till death. These two karmas are the original true self of human being. The third karma is the combination of Sanjitam and Prarabdham will give desire for a human and make it is Agamya karma. We can delete these karmas in our life by having deep meditation. As these bad imprints are removed from our life, we human will be able to spread love and kindness everywhere. Because of this true state of divinity come into our human body. Thank you so much for listening to me patiently and thank you for this opportunity. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Amma. Thank you, Amma.
Be blessed by the divine Anita Amma. What have I done? Presented so well and quoted that Kavide also, Marathini Levite, that song, and explained about the genetic center and the black box comparison is really good. That's what Swamiji says actually, as the black box in the flight. We have a genetic center which has all the imprints that all that are very well explained. The God plus imprints gives bad imprints is man and man minus imprints is God, right? That's my personal view here is we just can't add any imprints to God actually. So man minus imprints may be God, but God plus imprints is man. Somehow I'm not for that, but people used to say that. Okay. Then you explain about the karmas and Sanjita Prarabdha and Agamya karma. All that are very well explained. And here we can talk about that magnetism. All this are happening only due to magnetism, right? That has two functions. That is, one, keeping everything within, and whenever they want, that will expand and give us. That's what we used to learn in analysis of thought. What is the thought? How the thought emerges and all that. So the same way here, we can talk about that also. There's only nothing but magnetism. Suruki irupaga vaithal virithu kattudal, that and as much as it will get within itself, so that can be added a little some more points based on magnetism, that how it is imprinted within us using the biomagnetism, how it is imprinted with the universal magnetism only because of that, as the seed of any plant has, and as in time comes slowly the leaves comes. So, and the stem, flower, and vegetables or fruits. One by one, it has the stages to come up. The same way, whatever we have, whatever we are today, it is already imprinted in our genetic center. That is the day one when we started our life within our mother's womb. where the blueprint is started. That from there it is, everything is within. That is vidayil paramaha. So what we are today is already there in that one cell. So that can be little, can be elaborated little more. Nothing else, Amma. Otherwise, you did very well. Thank you very much. Be blessed by the divine, Amma.
Thank you, Amma. Would anyone like to share your thoughts, or if you have any questions, we can get it like that with the Amma.
The ultimate goal of this impromptu speeches is to prepare our masters and get them more into the concepts of Vedatriyam, well-versed, so that they can present themselves in front of a bigger and wider audience, and much more aspirants to spread Vedatriyam. So we are all working towards into one single goal of world peace. So everyone is actually giving and offering their time and efforts. And Mahan is actually guiding us, leading us in front of us. And the divine state is making everything is happening. Be blessed. Thank you all so much for thank witnessing all these in our path. Be blessed.
Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. I am learning a lot. So how well they were experienced in sharing their thoughts. That's very marvelous. I'm happy to be there, please. Thank you. Yeah, I have learned.
Right. Maybe I think we can conclude the session at this time. And I think we have 9:30 Kayakalpam in English. Tamil, right? Yeah.
Tamil,
yeah. Yeah, Tamil. And Kayakalpam in Tamil. Thank you. Yeah. Be blessed.